My name is David DeLuca. I'm a senior storage solutions architect for Amazon Web Services. In this video, I will demonstrate how to manage an Amazon FSx for ONTAP file system using NetApp Cloud Manager. Amazon FSx for ONTAP offers a fully featured NetApp ONTAP in AWS. It supports a wide array of enterprise-level data management features, such as multi-protocol, snapshots and cloning, replication, and storage efficiencies, with the simplicity, agility, and scalability of an AWS service. For existing ONTAP users, Amazon FSx for ONTAP allows you to run your applications in AWS without needing to change how you store or manage your data. Unlock the agility, scalability, and reliability of running your applications on AWS while continuing to leverage the same ONTAP capabilities that you're used to. Lastly, you can do more with your data. With FSx for ONTAP, your data is immediately available to a broad set of integrated AWS services, unlocking new opportunities for innovation and experimentation. You can manage the file system using native AWS tools, including the management console, command line interface, and FSx APIs and SDKs. You can also use native NetApp tools, including Cloud Manager and the NetApp ONTAP CLI and REST APIs. NetApp Cloud Manager provides a centralized user interface to manage, monitor, and automate ONTAP deployments in AWS and on-premises. Let's take a closer look at how to manage your Amazon FSx for ONTAP file system using NetApp Cloud Manager. From a web browser, navigate to cloudmanager.netapp.com. You can log in with an existing NetApp account or create a new one on this page. To manage an FSx for ONTAP file system, we will need to create a Cloud Manager connector. The connector enables Cloud Manager to securely communicate with your private network environment in AWS. The connector creation wizard is available in the top right menu. Click Create Your First Connector. On the provider screen, select Amazon Web Services, then click Continue. On the Get Ready screen, click Next. Provide IAM credentials and select the region where you want the connector to be placed. Define the connector name and appropriate IAM role. You can also leave the default option to automatically create a new IAM role with the required policy. For additional information, please reference the NetApp Cloud Manager documentation. Choose the connector network configuration and SSH key pair. Create or select a security group for the connector with adequate inbound and outbound traffic rules. Review the connector configuration and press Add to initiate its provisioning. This process will take several minutes. The connector has been created successfully. Now let's use Cloud Manager to create a new FSx for ONTAP file system. From the canvas, click Add Working Environment. Select Amazon Web Services, then Amazon FSx for ONTAP. Select or create the AWS credentials, which are assigned to the required IAM role. Enter a name for the file system and a password for the administrative user FSx admin. Select the deployment mode. Single AZ offers a cost-effective solution for development and non-production workloads, as well as disaster recovery replication targets. Multi-AZ file systems are designed to maintain availability of your data in the event that an availability zone is inaccessible. Multi-AZ is recommended for most production workloads. Specify the AWS region, VPC, and security group for the file system. For each node, select the availability zone and subnet that you want to assign. In multi-AZ deployments, virtual floating IP addresses are used for management and for mapping network shares. This facilitates a seamless failover and failback in case of an availability zone outage. these IP addresses should be from a site or range that does not belong to any existing VPC in your AWS account. This field can be left blank to have it auto-assigned and generated during deployment. Review the VPC routing table configuration that will be used by the floating IPs and adjust as needed. FSx for ONTAP integrates with AWS Key Management Service for data encryption at rest. You can select an encryption key that you have created or use the default AWS Managed Encryption option. Select the throughput and SSD storage capacity for the file system. You can also enter a custom provisioned IOPS value or leave it blank to accept the default setting of 3 IOPS per gigabyte of SSD storage. Also note that each file system is automatically attached to an unlimited capacity pool tier, which can be used to store infrequently accessed data. Review the FSx for ONTAP configuration and press Add to initiate the deployment. The newly created file system will be visible in the Cloud Manager canvas. Keep in mind that it will take several minutes for the deployment to complete. We can see the new file system, along with any S3 buckets that our account has access to. Clicking on the file system reveals additional information in the right-hand panel. To manage this file system, click Enter Working Environment. From this screen, we can see the amount of SSD capacity that has been provisioned and used, as well as the amount of data stored in the capacity pool, along with many other file system details. Let's take this opportunity to create our first volume. Click Add Volume. Enter a name and size for the volume. Each volume needs to be assigned to a storage virtual machine, which is a virtual, isolated file server with its own administrative credentials and IP address for accessing data. I'm going to leave the default snapshot policy. From the Volume Protocol screen, you can select NFS or SIFS. Volumes can also be presented via iSCSI using the ONTAP CLI. The Storage Efficiency feature allows you to enable deduplication, compression, and compaction. When you enable the tiering policy on a volume, FSx for ONTAP automatically transitions data between primary storage and the capacity pool storage based on your data access patterns. Tiering allows you to reduce your storage costs and store virtually unlimited data in a cluster. I'm going to select Auto, which tiers cold snapshots and user data from the active file system to the capacity pool tier. Review the configuration and click Add. We can also use NetApp Cloud Manager to discover existing FSx for ONTAP file systems. From the canvas, click Add Working Environment, select Amazon Web Services, then Amazon FSx for ONTAP. Simply press the Click Here link. On the credentials page, select or create a user that has access to view these file systems. Then select the region. Cloud Manager has discovered all of the FSx for ONTAP file systems that exist within my account in this region. I'm going to select one of them and hit Add. I can reveal additional information about this file system by clicking on it and manage it by clicking Enter Working Environment. Clicking on the Volumes button reveals detailed information, including the disk type, provision capacity, and how much of the SSD tier and capacity pool tier are being utilized by the volume. This concludes our demonstration. Thank you for your time.